Hello dear friends and welcome back to our simulator. Today I start the simulator, now it's running, so I get some alarms, and one of the alarms that I get it today it's auxiliary boiler feed water pressure low. So the reason is that as you can see my pump here, it's running dry, it get a pressure low, but I need to stop the pump so I will not burn it. So direct, if we see that we do not have any pressure to our pump, and also this will help the ampere meter. When you will check the ampere meter, you will see that the pump is working without load and it's about 1 or 2 amperage. And also the first thing that you should do is to check the level on the feed water filter tank or gasket tank, and as you can see it's very, very low. So what I will need to do, I will need to open the filling. There is 2 valves for filling, there is a automatic filling and also a manual filling. Verify that your automatic filling is working properly, or you can use your valve for filling. And first of all, after this situation, the best condition is to stop your pump, and as the level increases here, as the level goes up inside the tank, let's say it will be to the normal level, and you will have a positive pressure on your pump suction here. You will be able to make some air vent from the pump casing, so you will vent all the air inside in the pump casing and the impeller, and next on you will be able to resume the operation of the pump. So obviously when you will get close to the pump, the temperature of the casing will be really, really high, and in some cases it's so hot, the casing, that you cannot touch it. So for the moment I will erase the pen here for the indication. So now I have both valves open, and also have in mind when you're filling really, really fast, and if you have a lot of consumption from the line, because from the same line you also supply the purifiers, and probably some of the purifiers can get a trip. So also, as you can see here, the hydroform tank, it's really, really pressed, and we have a lot of consumption. That's why for the moment I will stop the filling, and I will leave the pumps to fill up, as you can see, to get the pace of the filling. All that things must be taken in consideration, and really, really I have seen they play a big role when you are filling. It's real, like this simulator here that we have, and the good thing that simulator give us also the opportunity to see some real life items here on a controlled area. Also the person that are checking the feed filter tank or the gasket tank every day should keep a note about how many liters he's filling, so there will be also a control of what is going on of our boiler water consumption. Another thing that it's really important to tell about is that as you can see, with one valve it's okay, it can't get it, so I will leave the automatic filling. Another thing that we need to tell, that we have a normal evaporation from our feed filter tank or gasket tank every day. And as you can see, there is a vent on the aft of the vessel, And there is also a really, really big consumption because we keep our filter tank about to 81 to 100 to 80 to 90 degrees. And there is also a evaporation produced through the time. So we have losses also from there. This is a natural losses. So after filling our feed filter tank, let's start our pump to see if we have any pressure. Okay, our pressure is good. So by the time this alarm will be eliminated, and also I get one more alarm, which is on the fuel oil settling tank. And as you remember, I set my pump to automatic. So the pump is stopped, probably the alarm or the stop sensor was not activated in the proper area. I have seen like that. I have seen that the pump will be stopped when it will be filled enough. And the temperature, it's okay. And let's see also our fuel oil purifying system. Okay, it's here. Service, it's full. Let's check also our transfer pump of gasoil, if everything is stopped. Okay, service, it's fill up. So for the moment, we are okay. We have eliminated most of the alarms. And I will return back to our purifier. So our purifier, it's not working. I will start it back again. So we will need to answer once again all the items that asking here on the panel. And then we will start the pump, the heater and the purifier. So for the moment, we have everything ready. Everything is ready here. We have not closed any valve. But when your purifier will be you will preserve for a long standstill, it's necessary to close the water, to isolate some of the valves for the feed from the pump. And these valves here for the recirculation, you can keep them in the same position. It's not necessary to close them because you will lose the set point for the pressure that you have adjusted for the recirculation and for the feed of the purifier. So let's press start, and all the sequence of the purifier has started. So today we have this troubleshooting a little bit. Most of our system are working properly. Now this is about the 7 or 8 day that I'm running this simulator. Most of the systems are activated already. And as you can see also, I use my stern tube. Everything is working here. We have a positive pressure. We are working for the ballast. Okay, even if we have our tank more than high on the high level, okay, this is not proper because we will not get a proper alarms. We can adjust it by draining back to the tank here. But even if we are monitoring the system closely every day, and all these tanks must be monitoring by everyday basis during the morning rounds and checking, and also on the evening, we get a really, really important view on our systems of what's going on. So main engine, it's supply with the fuel already. Let's see our air ventilation system. Okay, we have all the fans, mostly of the fans working. Let's start also. We do not have source here. Okay, we will find where it is later on. Let's see about the lube oil transfer or some tank. It's okay. Stern tube, okay. and what we need to care about it for our sludge formation through the time. Let's see our feed water. Okay, it will get slowly on the normal level. And let's see our sludge. Okay, filler overflow. Still, we are okay. And if you will ask me about how much to keep the filler purifier sludge tank, I will tell you to keep it close to the alarm limit, but the alarm limit to not be here like that, to be somewhere here, so you will quickly determine what is going on with the sludge and the purifier itself. So today we will use our incinerator. Okay, let's say that we are in the safe zone to use that by the regulations, and we are far from the areas that are protected, and the regulation said that we can use our incinerator. So what we will need to prepare, we will prepare our tanks. Our tanks are full enough, and it's really, really necessary that if you will going to burn, you will have about 80 to 85 degrees your tank prepared. If you will get them more, let's say that the temperature will be of the service or these waste oil tanks will be 100, probably you can damage your waste oil pump if it's made from a stator and rotor. A stator probably, mostly, which is made with rubber. And also there is some sensors set it on the pump casing, which will not allow you to run the incinerator if the temperature is more than a preset value. But what most of engineers do, they pick up this sensor from the hood to be able to use the incinerator. Okay, this is not a good idea, but as I have seen, this part, this stator and rotor, will serve about for 6 months. And we have made such videos. We have made such videos in the channel. You can find all these kind of videos, which will be really, really helpful if you have the same system. So we have some sludges from purifier here, and also scavenging drain box tank. So in the scavenging drain box tanks will be more solid. The sludges that we have there, here we will have more fuel, which have a lot of calorific value. Probably there will be some water. In the oily bilge tank, probably there will be more water from the drains, from the service and settling tanks. So it's a good thing that the proper media that you will transfer, let's say oil or fuel, will be as much as possible less water, because with the water you cannot burn very good and you will have some trouble. As you can see here also, our sludge pump, it's a little bit different. It's made with a worm here. This is a metallic worm, a rotor, and it's working inside a stator. And here we have probably a gear pump, which is much better for to handling the high temperature of these tanks here. So today we will burn from waste oil settling tank. So in the IEOPP manual, inside this manual, we can get all the specifications, the quantity of the tank, the capacity of the tank, the frame that the tank is located, the proper name, and everything later on will be filled up on our oil record book. So it's really, really important, whatever we are feeling about the handling from the tanks, from all the tanks that been stated in IEOPP, because we cannot add tanks on the oil record book that are not included in the IEOPP certificate. This is a international oil prevention of pollution certificate that have a description of the tanks that you will be used for the proper management of the sludges. So later on we will see the capacity of our incinerator. We will see how much cubic meters of sludges will be burned through the inserter time, and also we will measure our tank to calculate how many cubic meters will be burned in particular time. So if our incinerator are burning, let's say 150 liters per hour, okay, we cannot state that our incinerator are burning 160 or 170, okay? We are going against the specifications of the maker, and this thing shows that for the inspector and for the port state control will show that your equipment cannot burn and you have not this quantity. So where this quantity goes? This is the next question from the authorities. And a really, really good thing for me, it's as much as possible in the future will be avoided to use the incinerator, because there is a lot of amount of oil contained inside in the sludges, which can be recirculated again, regenerated, and supply as oil or some kind of fuel that can be refined or regenerated and reproduce again and will be used somewhere. So by burning inside the incinerator, this is my opinion, it's a really, really waste of energy and time that I have seen, because we are burning something that is reusable, and also we produce also some fumes through running the incinerator. It's not really, really a clean air that produced from the exhaust. That you can imagine that sludges are burned there, probably they have some contamination of the fuel particles, like aluminium inside, and this is heavy metals which the fuel contains inside, or there can be some kind of chemicals that will be used from the refineries. So this fuel here and the oil, it's not really, really clean 100%, and when we open the tanks for the inspection, we can see really, really some heavy material on the bottom collected. So the best way for me is to give on shore, because we are also in the port now, and we will prepare the line. We must be verified that all the other lines are closed, and we will select our particular tank, which is our fuel oil purifier sludge tank. So because we are in the port, we are in good facilities that will proper handle this and will not burn, will regenerate or refine, so we will give it a sure. So our pump is ready, our pump sludge pump is ready, and let's see, it's here. Okay, we will set it to fuel oil. Let's say this is our sludge pump. Okay, we can run it manual because we are standby there. We are standby here, and as you can see also our pump, it's on the light. The temperature, it's really, really hot. We do not like to run on this temperature in any case, because we will damage the stator. But for the moment we can okay, also this is really, really hot. Also this we will close, there's nothing there. Also this, and we will reduce also the steam consumption. Let's close also this. As much as possible, if you are not needed steam so much, or you will keep your heating, it depends from your boiler capabilities and also the economy that you would like to do through the time. It's really, really important to know, my dear friends, that if you are opening the valves, it's better to open them full, because you will avoid the damage to the valve seat of the steam. If you are opening crack or on half about, you will have a damaged seat, and also will be damaged the body of the valve itself. So now we have flow here. We are giving to our shore, because our tank is really, really hot. What we can do now, we can, one moment, I will see here. Okay, we can close the steam, but it will take really, really long time to cool down, because as we know, the oil can keep the heat for a prolonged time. And here we have left and to right also, we are going to give. We can give also our lube oil purifier sludge. And what is the best way for change over the tanks? Okay, if this tank it's in the same level, it's not big deal. Try before you finish this tank, open the other tank also, so it will go simultaneously and you will not lose the suction. So let's see here, let's see, the level is going down. Okay, because if we leave this one, this only one, a tank for suction, we will lose the suction. Okay, we will see that from the pressure gauge, and direct we must open the other valve without interrupt the pump, so we will not suction any air to the system. Let's see that we can suction also bilge. So after on, when we will finish our discharge of this and to the shore, okay, to the shore facilities, when we will finish all the oil like that, what we will do, the best way is to give next on our bilges and from the bilge system. So let's trace now where is our bilge tank connected to our pump, to our sludge pump. Let's see from where is the suction to sludge oil system. It's going here, and let's see, probably, as I remember, we have a separate bilge pump here, and from with that pump we can give in the same line, or there is a separate line. So in one vessel, which was a little bit old, we had the same line for the sludge to supply, only we changed some valves, and we have the same line for the oil. What we did when we finished with the oil, the next step was the water. So the water will clean up the line, and the line will remain as much as possible clean. So this is the valve also that, as I can see, it's suction from here, from the chemical tank. So probably if we close this valve here, one moment, if we close this valve here, so let's see, we have flow still, but it will suction here from this tank. Let's see if the level reduces. Air cooler chemical cleaning tank. If it will not suction, probably the level it's already really, really low. So let's go back again. So now our pump are not having any suction. Let's open again. And let's see also how we can transfer our waste oil tanks. One way is that that what we can do, okay, I will stop the pump also for the moment. Another thing is how we can transfer. So this is the filling line. This is the filling line. So if we have our tanks full, let's say, and we are arrival in the port, we can drain them here to, let's see, where is our solutions? We can burn them in the incinerator. And the other thing is to send to bilge primary separation tank. Let's see. Okay, no, here we cannot send them to this system because it would make them dirty. The overflow goes here to waste oil tanks. Some of these tanks you can make a drain them back again to waste oil collecting tank. You can drain them back here again, but here we can see that there is overflow, and only this drain, if there is any water that collected on the bottom, because the water mostly collects down because it's heavier, so we can drain this water here, but must make with really, really careful, because if you press really, really hard these valves here, you will throw also in the line oil, and you don't like your separator, because this is our oil water separator. You do not like in any case to get any oil there. So, what we can do now, we have explained what is the possibilities with our waste oil tanks. And now we're gonna start our incinerator. So let's see, let's turn on the source of the incinerator. Let's see where is the source available of our incinerator. Let's see, and we must search the panels. So all the group starting panels must be checked, and mostly incinerator panel located on the top. Switchboard engine room. This is the switchboard on engine room. So somewhere here it will be. Switchboard engine room. Let's see. Okay, let's make it on this one. Incinerator cooling fan. Okay. Other panels. Okay, let's reset it. Let's go back again. Let's see other group. Other one. So if I remember, we had some problem, yes, with these switches here. Okay, this is for the galley. Okay, let's go back again to our incinerator. Let's see also our purifier, how it's going on. Our purifier, okay, everything here runs properly. We have separation, our temperature is good. Let's see our tanks. Everything is fine here, the temperatures are okay. And let's go back to our incinerator. Let's back to our incinerator to see from here. Here's our incinerator.
Yeah, there is a lot of
items. Okay, let's check it. So how I access it before? Not from the drain system, from the sludge. Sludge, where is sludge? Sludge. Where is it? Did you see it? Sludge oil system. Okay, here. Here it is. The feed door. It's for burning the. Let's see if something is working. How to start this Mayura? Let's say maybe there is some other buttons for using that. Also, as you can see, there is buttons for emergency stop and operate the pump, the sludge pump. So for the moment, because we have finished our suction, later on we will receive a receipt from the batch that receive our sludge. There will be stated the port, the quantity that they will be taken, and also there will be stated a lot of information about the vessels, IMO number, the quantity, the time of starting, receiving and finish. Let's see where this system starts. Okay, breaker on. So by pressing this button, breaking on, we have a source. Okay, we have also indication that is 36, and our incinerator now has the same exactly temperature that engine room has. So let's start our cooling fan. Depends on the incinerator, there is a different kind of design. So here we can select what we are going to burn. For me, it's much better to have this kind of selector, because it's much easier from the touchpad, as the touchpad monitor sometimes do not receive the order. And here directly you can select what kind of waste you going to burn. When you are going to burn some waste, do not overload your incinerator, because it will damage it. It will make it a lot of cracks. And let's start waste oil only here, and we will burn waste oil. So let's press lamp test to see if everything is working or the alarms are working. And let's prepare our line. So the suction of our waste oil will be from number one tank. Let's see here if we have any water. We have any water? No, we do not have. Okay. We have prepared our mixture. Okay. And as you can see, also this line here going up on the funnel. So any evaporation and any water that will be evaporated from our tank will go to the atmosphere like water and humidity. So this is our tank suction here. As you can see, there is also quick closing valves here. So we will suction from here. We'll passing to these filters. And later on, it will go to, one moment, to our pump here. Okay, and our pump will deliver here. And also we have the compressed air for atomizing. And diesel oil, it's only needed for starting the pilot, or for the initial start only. Just to preheat the chamber and reach a desired temperature, that manufacturer have set it, so later on we can switch to another stage and we can burn our waste oil, because our waste oil needs a really, really high temperature to be burned properly. So let's see. Okay, this is the diesel oil pressure side and this is the suction side. Okay, we have the supply here from the boiler system. We have supply to our incinerator. Okay, it's open here. Our tank, our diesel tank. Okay, everything, it's open. So we can go to our incinerator and we can give a start to see how the system is working. So we start our combustion on. Okay, now there is a purging process and we can see here all the process inside. So you can see that the flow was increased. There is a fire, starting of fire here inside. We have an indication. The temperature also increases. That means the fire already inside. Slowly, slowly it will be increased, and next on the valve for feeding will open here for the waste oil pump. There is also some control of the pump, that the RPM will be increases, depends of the stage that the incinerator are at the moment. So always also, if you have any problem with the incinerator, you will see some vibrations, you will see some unusual noise, it's always there is a emergency button. And also if you see some items of that happening, report to your superior officers in the engine room. Try to inform her that it's something is going wrong, that you hear something. It's not anything bad if you hear something and report that. So the temperature increases, it's still low. We have still purging. And here also we can see the stages and the indication. We have select waste oil here. So let's see how this incinerator working. Always remember, you must be in the proper area to burn and working incinerator. And also this relies also in equipment such oily bilge separators. Always ask the bridge for permission to work such equipment, because they also have maps and areas. They also know that we are locating close to some islands, to some specific zones. Through the time, the refractory of the incinerator gets damaged, and it really, really costs a lot to make this refractory again, for building, for rebuilding. And most of the times, if the incinerator are working non-stop and there is not any facilities to give all these items, these items will be held on the ship, the solid, I mean. And the problem is that the space of the vessel also sometimes became stuck with these garbages. And this is really, really unpleasant condition. This is also a dangerous condition for the fire, because as I have seen, sometimes there is a lot of garbages and the garbage room is full until on the top. In such situations, if for any reason they will get any fire, the sprinklers will not working properly as designed, because the garbage take all the area, all the available area, and also coverage the spray nozzles. And that situation and the proper management of the garbage, it's really, really essential, not only for the health of the crew and also for the safety of the crew. Try as much as possible also, if you have any garbages in your room, or try as much as possible to segregate the garbages through the system that your company has, plastic with plastic, metals with metals, and by this segregation you will reduce as much as possible the unnecessary quantities of garbage itself. So do not try to mix them, try to separate them from the beginning. And if it's possible to burn the garbage, if these solid waste are not so difficult to burn, like say oily rugs, because oily rugs need really, really a lot of time to burn them. If there is carton, the carton can be burned much, much easier than the rugs. Also, the chief officer has some part of the oily record book, which he also enters the quantity that should be burned, and also burned through the time. There is exactly quantity, what time started burning of this garbage, what time finished, the exact quantity. And this time mostly it's on the beginning, when the incinerator started in the morning, because at that time the incinerator, it's cooled down already, it's easy to open, to clean and remove the ashes, and then to replenish back again with new garbage that has been collected through the previous days and segregated properly. Also, a lot of incinerators has installed a label of what is prohibited to burn and what is the proper usage of the incinerator, so you will avoid any troubles by burning. Incinerator cannot burn everything, and this must be in mind, because by burning whatever you like, you can create, and you can also avoid the safe guidances, and this is the worst thing. Try to not do that, because you will get in trouble for sure. So also our incinerator, through the cooling fans here that installed, there is some passages through the furnace wall, and air is being circulated and cooled down the surface and the bricks that installed inside. So this helps to keep it cool and integrated, because the heat, as we know, and as you can see also here, it's now 676 degrees, can melt everything, almost the iron starts to melt. That's why there is a specific bricks, furnace bricks, that helps to keep it in good shape. So let's see, our waste oil pump still increases. Okay. Waste oil. Let's see from here. For the moment, we have a really, really small flow here and really, really small pressure. The pressure must be somewhere around there, 0.2. If it's in bar, okay, it's a little bit low, it must be about 0.8 to 1 bar. Depends always the manufacturer and the pump itself. So let's see, the temperature has stabilized here, And let's see what we can do. So we switch to our waste oil. Let's see here, the level remains the same. So now for the moment we are not burning any sludge, and if we are burning, it's really really little the quantity. So also you will have a lot of consumption of air because the incinerator working with air for atomizing, and you will have a lot of consumption of air. So you will, your compressor, your service air compressor will start and stop more frequently. As I can see here, the waste oil pump's working. It's working not so much. Waste oil and auxiliary burner. Let's see here if we select another program, what will happen. Let's select it like that. So now I can see that the pump started on and increase with temperature. So as we can see, because we had working only waste oil, the temperature not increases more than one preset level. So that shows that our quality of our waste oil, it's not so good. So with the auxiliary burner now, we have the supply of diesel oil, and you can see how quickly the temperature rises. But now we have the consumption of the diesel now for the moment. Let's see, and let's see also if we have any water presented here. So we have flow. Let's see also here what we get. So it's coming from here, from waste oil drain. This is probably water and this oil. So let's drain again. Okay, there will be humidity G here if there is any water presented, but probably the quality, it's not so good here. So let's see, we have completely stop of the pump. Let's see now how the program is working. Temperature increases. So our pump is stopped now. Why? For what reason it stop? It starts and stop. Okay, the temperature increases. As you can see also, there is two flames, two burners here. That means the diesel and the waste oil running together. So for the moment I will stop the auxiliary burner to see if waste oil alone can handle it. And the return, I will open the return back again to see. So I will have the suction from here and send it all the way there. So if there is any recirculation, it will go here. Back to the tank again. So the temperature really, really drops. Let's put it back again. Okay, close. Misfire, flame failure. So we had a misfire flame failure, and this is really really occasional thing when we do not have, let's say, proper heating, or our quality of the fuel it's really really bad. So what we can do, we can try again to start our incinerator. Alarm reset. So we will set it again with waste oil and burner. Probably also the misfire that we get here, it's by changing of the valves. If you are sudden changing or changing the valves improperly, there is lack of pressure of supply of waste oil, and that's why we get this damage. For sure, from somewhere we must adjust the pressure. We can adjust the pressure of sludge that's supplied to our pump. So I will run it again and again, and in the next video we will see together how to work this incinerator and how to get it working properly. Thank you, my dear friends, that you have watched this video. Don't forget to subscribe, don't forget to press the bell button, and to share the video with your friends that interested in marine engineering. Thank you, and see you again in the next video from AdventureStory Channel. Bye bye.